all people come to him, come to the way of Sultan al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one, most praised one in divine presence, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نويت الأربعين نويت الاعتكاف نويت الخلوة نويت العزة نويت الرياضة نويت السلوك نويت الصيام في هذا المسجد أطيع الله وأطيع الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Before we go back to tafsir, Maulana has signaled to us to speak about the reality of adab in the tariqah and what should the murid look when he perform his adab, his good manners, the good manners. What are the importance and the status of good manners in the way of the Naqshbandiyun? These are notes of Sheikh Sharafuddin, Grand Sheikh, and Maulana Sheikh, Grand Sheikh of Maulana Sheikh Abdullah al-Daghestani and the Grand Sheikh of Maulana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani. And it is important to know where we stand, or else we don't improve. Because if we don't know where we are putting our feet, we will not be able to progress, because when you know where you put your feet, you don't put it on a cliff and it falls down, as the ayah says.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أفمن أسس بنيانه على تقوى من الله ورضوان خير أم من أسس بنيانه على شفا جرف هار فانهار به في نار جهنم والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين.
It says that who built his بنيانه, his building, on a cliff which is falling down is better, or the one if he build his building on fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and piety and sincerity? The first one will go to Jahannam, the second one, as if he build with taqwa, will go to paradise. So we want to know where we are in relationship to our many years with in tariqah. Some people, they say that they have power of representing a sheikh. And this applied not only to Naqshbandi tariqah, but it is Mumayyaza, is distinguished between the old tariqahs. But it applies to any person as a Muslim or a mu'min. And al-adab wal-muhafaza ala al-ahkam al-shar'iyya. Discipline is to keep protecting, keep doing all the necessary principles of Sharia. First, he say, al-muhafaza ala al-ahkam al-shar'iyya. That's the head of the Tariqah of the Golden Chain of the Naqshbandi Order, Sayyidina Sheikh Sharafuddin al-Daghestani, who is the uncle of Sheikh Abdullah al-Faiz al-Daghestani. He is saying this, and I am quoting it from his manuscript, which I have. So we have to follow what Allah ordered us and what Prophet ﷺ ordered us. Because Prophet ﷺ said, Allah said in Holy Quran, in relationship to Prophet, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever Prophet gives to you, you must take. Not وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوا بَعْضٍ مِّنْ, little bit of it or some of it. No, you have to take all of it. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ, and whatever he prohibited you from doing, you leave it. This is the big frame of adab. What falls inside that, on every part of Islamic fiqh or hadith or Quran, every ayah in Quran has its own adab. Every word in Holy Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has a way to follow, and you cannot follow from the bottom or from the middle. You have to follow from the beginning of the ayah, or in case of hadith, you have to begin with the, from the beginning of the hadith. Means take all the consideration that goes with that hadith or with that ayah or with some Islamic fiqh jurisprudence, you have to follow. بحيث لا يجري لا يجري على العبد ما لم يسوغه الشرع. And you are not responsible for anything that Sharia left it away. So you are concerned with Sharia only, and that's why, not in the mentality of Western, what they say about Sharia. When you say to them Sharia, they are afraid. Sharia is adab, is respect to Allah and His Prophet. Any part of the Sharia has its own way, its own adab. Even the awrad in Sharia, in Tariqah, what you begin with? Shahada. To clean yourself, it's an adab. To go into the awrad, you have to begin by cleaning yourself. And to clean yourself is by shahada. What we say?
أشهد
أن إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. That cleans us. Take away all sins, bring you pure in front of the amal that you are going to do according to Sharia. So murid has to follow this way. كل عمل لا يبدأ ببسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فهو أبتر. Any amal you want to do does not begin with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, that amal is cut, no continuation, no progress, no profit, no fruits, nothing. So first written here, something that has a fruit, you get benefit. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Beginning with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, which means in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beneficent and the most merciful. And then salawat on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You cannot say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim only, but you have to add Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidil Mursaleen, Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala Ali wa sahbihi ajma'in. Now you are ready, now you are on the train, you are ready to move. And that's why when you write a letter or you write or you begin amal, you say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Wassalatu Wassalamu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. So here you are entering, jumping on the train to move. The reality of adab, the good manners toward every amal you do. Try as much as you can to put away shaitan. Because any amal you want to do, shaitan is going to enter and try to spoil your amal. So Sadat al-Naqshbandiyya, they are telling us what is the reality of adab, haqiqatul adab. The secret of adab in many ways, in different parts and different ways, and we'll go through them one by one. First, the murid has to you are pulling something in order to make it stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger. You are building something to become stronger and stronger, and then you move with it. وَأَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ
وَأَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَّ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَّكُمْ وَآخَرِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَهُمُ اللَّهُ يَعْلَمُهُمْ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يُوَفَّ إِلَيْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تُظْلَمُونَ.
Recite back, part by part.
وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ.
Prepare as much as you can from power.
وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَّ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَّكُمْ.
And from the horses that you prepare for fighting enemies, you need, at that time, you need more horses. So Allah is saying, don't fight them when you don't have power. Prepare as much until you will have strong power, like a huge amount of horses that they are under your command, that they can move by your command.
وَآخَرِينَ مِن دُونِهِمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَهُمُ اللَّهُ يَعْلَمُهُمْ.
When you prepare all this, and you prepare all these horses, that means all these good desires that you have in your soul, in your ego, you have the good desire, you have the bad. So prepare all these good desires for a work that you are going to do for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you might frighten shaitan away and run away from you.
وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يُوَفَّ إِلَيْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تُظْلَمُونَ.
And whatever you give, sadaqah, in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will reward you for that. So that's why you have to prepare yourself to be strong. What you have to look after within yourself. They said, and you lahiz al-murid jami'a anfasi. For the murid, that's why we say we are not murid. We are lovers to our shuyukh, We love them, we love what they say, we follow. But murid, he has to observe every breath that he is breathing in and out. It has to be according to Sharia. Means, if you are angry with someone and you are breathing in and out with anger, that's considered against you as a murid, and that will bring you down one level. Then you are not a murid when you are going to get your anger within your action, your act. That's why he said, يجب على المريد أن يلاحظ المريد جميع أنفاسه. The murid has to look after every breath he's breathing. That's the level of murid. Do we have that?
No.
Partially yes. Little bit is okay. Especially when someone you like, people that you look at them and you see they are no, not sleep. They are meditating on their breath in and out. But you think they are crazy, but they are not crazy. Their heart is connected there somewhere. If the heart is connected to Allah and His Prophet, you are okay. But if your heart is connected somewhere else, dunya life, then you are not on the right way. So it depends. You see many people, you say to him, what you are thinking? When he is thinking and contemplating, you say to him, what if he feels shy to tell you, I am meditating and shaitan is waiting for me there, because I am not meditating to Allah and His Prophet, to something else. So you have to be careful, murid has to be careful where he is breathing in and out. That's why in tariqah and in many other tariqah, most of them, they make the zikr in and out. Is that what you call it?
Nafas.
Nafas, we know nafas. Tarjami bil Arabic. So he breathes in, meditating, and he breathes out, taking the poison and the bad desires, throwing it out. So that's why who is bringing in, who bringing out. And he must not be heedless. Heedless, not knowing where he is standing, or not breathing in and out according to Islamic Sharia. That's contemplation has to be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sharia say you have to contemplate and meditate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to His creation. That is the way you save yourself. And Allah said in Holy Quran, الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهِ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا.
الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ.
That's our way. It's very simple, very open. Are you following it? You will be following the Prophet ﷺ in his footsteps. You will be following the Awliya Allah in their footsteps. You will be following Sultan al-Awliya in his footsteps. You are following Islam by following what is necessary to do, and Allah said it, openly those who wants to control their breath. It is a very quick way, is zikrullah. Alladhina yadhkuruna Allah, they are able to make tafakkur, they are able to observe and look after their breath. Because they breathe with zikrullah in and out, in and out. It is said, I heard it from Grand Sheikh many times, that Sultan al-Awliya is not an easy title. It's a loaded person, that he will be in his time as Sultan of everything. It's not a word that it is so simple on the tongue. He was describing what is Sultan al-Awliya means. He has Sultan al-Zikr. If he is a Sultan of Awliya, he must carry Sultan al-Zikr. If he doesn't carry Sultan al-Zikr, he is not Sultan al-Awliya. He is a wali, it's okay. But that title is not fit for that person. Any person who, too many shiur, too many different tariqah, every person loves his sheikh, call him Sultan al-Awliya. But if he carries Sultan al-Zikr, yes, he can be Sultan al-Awliya. And that title can be on different levels in between Awliya Allah. But the highest level is the one that carries Sultan al-Zikr. And Sultan al-Zikr is what allow these awliya to become kings on the kingdom that Allah will give to them. And that's why it is mentioned that zikrullah is the highest level of someone who wants to open the door for him to enter into heaven. So what is Sultan al-Zikr? You know? Means you didn't read the Naqshbandi Sufi way. Sultan al-Zikr depend on the Sultan of that time. And there were 9 in the Naqshbandi order. 9 sheikhs that they become Sultan al-Awliya because they carry Sultan al-Zikr. Sultan al-Zikr means when you, through your tayyul lisan, to fold, when you fold your tongue, because we know between mashayikh, there is tayyul zaman, tayyul masafa, tayyul lisan, tayyul kutub, means to fold yawma natwi sama katayi sijilli al-kutub, when in the day when we fold the skies and the universe, and we fold them like folding a book, means all mawjudat, all what Allah has created with their hikmah and their wisdom and their knowledge and everything that explain creation is within the in the fold of the book. If you are folding your book. So when you open, a wali open, knows all these secrets what is there. So tayyul lisan is like tayyul masafa. When you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, there are awliya, they appear in another place. And this I observe it very well. I saw it from Mawlana Sheikh Nazim one time. Not one time, but many times, but this was one of the, that everyone saw it. And what that is, tayul zaman or tayul masafa, to fold and then unfold, appear. Fold, move in space, then appear. You unfold. So we come back to Sultan al-Zikr. What I saw that story is in the late 70s, Prime Minister of Lebanon, he was a very good person, with the mayor of Tripoli, Lebanon, they were going for Hajj. And Mawlana Sheikh Nazim was in our home in Lebanon, in Tripoli. They came asking Mawlana to accompany them. And Mawlana said, no, I cannot, I have things to do, I am going back to Damascus. I cannot do that. They were disappointed because they love Mawlana Sheikh and they want him to, their prime minister at that time called Rashid Karami. So in any case, they left. And after Hajj finished, they came to, they knew that Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is in Tripoli. They are from Tripoli also. They came to visit and to complain, because they contacted us, they have a claim against Mawlana Sheikh. A nice claim, not in the bad meaning. They came and they said, "Ya Sheikh, we love you. We invited you to go with us to Hajj and to perform it in an easy way, Prime Minister." They give him very nice hospitality. "But you prefer to go with someone else." And we were looking at them, what they are saying. On Tawaf, the story is when they were in Tawaf, they saw Mawlana Sheikh Nazim and they spoke with him in Tawaf, and they were going around seven times around Kaaba in circumambulating, and Mawlana Sheikh Nazim was in circumambulating with them. And he has one person from this side and one from that side, they don't know, but we know that these are awliyaullah. Accompany him. Everyone was surprised, because everyone knows that Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is in our home, he's there. He never moved. And they saw him in Hajj, in Tawaf. And they spoke with him. If they saw him from far, they would say they might they didn't see well. They are confused. But they spoke with him and they are continuing the Tawaf with him. So that is tayu zaman, tayul makan. Is to fold the space or fold the time, make it short, in 1 second you are there. Like now technology is like tayu zaman, because it fold. When you call someone in China, in 1 second they connect you. That power, energy, that until now no one knows how it works, because everything goes back to energy, time goes back to energy. Grand Sheikh said, may Allah bless his soul, He said, after I die, you are going to see miracles in the world, beginning from people able to reach each other in few seconds. This is like 60 years ago. There was no technology, computers and telephones and so. So they can see, they know. So tayu zaman is to fold the time. Tayu makan is to fold the space and move in it. Lisan zikr, tayu lisan. So you fold your tongue in order that can read quickly. And Grand Sheikh said, Sayyidina Abu Yazid al-Bastami had the power for one time to complete the Holy Quran in tayyul lisan. In folding the tongue, he was able to read the Quran from beginning to an end in short time. Short time, which I mean less than 1 minute. With that power, as Grand Sheikh said. He said, these nine awliya, which I mentioned in the book, you go buy the book. He didn't read. These nine awliyas, between them, some of them, they did that two times, or three times, or four times, or nine times maximum, except one who was able to do complete the Holy Quran from beginning to end with tayyul lisan, not only one time, but in with every breath in and breath out, he was completing the Holy Quran. Awliya. This, today, if someone listen to us, they say we are crazy. We are not crazy because we saw that. Because we did seclusion and we saw some of these miracles. So for us, we saw it. It's obvious. For you, you did not do seclusion, or you don't have a powerful sheikh like Sultan al-Awliya, then of course you are going to say, how is that possible? Allah, inshallah, will open to your heart one day. Amen. So that is Sultan al-Zikr. Breathing in, breathing out, completing the recitation of the whole Quran. And this is specialty only for nine awliya in the Naqshbandi order. So Grand Sheikh said, Sheikh Sharafuddin, because he was toward the end of the chain, now how much Grand Sheikh did it, he doesn't speak about himself, but Mawlana Sheikh Nazim spoke on behalf of him. He can explain that. But we are not going to explain it because people's hearts might not accept. So Sheikh Sharafuddin, in every breath, was completing the whole Quran without stopping. He died, same age. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that takes him in the same age as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 63 years on Monday, in Rabi' al-Awwal, he passed away. So the murid, we go back. Allah said, those who make zikrullah, remember me, I will turn them to meditate on this universe and to take information, realities from that, and this is how they can advance themselves and control and observe and control their inspirations and control the Islamic Sharia well, and to be able to correct themselves when they are seeing themselves moving away. So الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِ. يعني in every movement in your body, when you stand up, some people when you stand up, the blood pressure goes down, you faint. When you stand up, means you are moving all your body and moving all your mind will be concentrating how and holding you not to fall, because everything goes through the mind. Sitting, when you are relaxing. Today they make massage chair to relax. So when you sit and you contemplate, you don't need massage chair, that will be a massage for your heart. Wa qiyama wa qu'udan wa 'ala junubihim, and laying down means the whole system is working together. What will happen? Adkuruna Allah qiyama wa qu'udan wa 'ala junubihim wa yatafakkaruna. At that time the heart, the body, the mind, every cell in your body moving during the day, take you to contemplation and meditation. في خلق السماوات والأرض, in the creation of heavens and earth, means the reality of the secret of creation of heaven and earth will be open to you with Zikrullah. The key for it is Zikrullah. As we said, Sultan al-Zikr. So for Zikrullah, you will open heavens and earth. It will open for you. What you think about Sultan al-Zikr, what will open? It will open to the wali to see all his murids in one time, in one minute he can see all of them separate. All of them in the same time he sees them, he look at them, and one doesn't overlap with the other. He can see all of them. What do you think about Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? He can see all the Ummah, he can see all the creation, he can see all heavens. Allah gave him power because he said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. Muhammad is, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his name is being raised with Allah's name, to give him honor and to give him power to see what cannot be seen. We will stop here and we will continue inshallah tomorrow. So he must not be heedless of his breath. He has to look how he is breathing in and breathing out. And it's not difficult when you train yourself breathing in and breathing out, you will find that it will work by itself. As when you do Zikrullah, when you do Allah, 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 you meditate on what you in your heart, time after time, you will feel the heart saying Allah. Even you are closing your mouth, Allah, and as soon as you begin zikr, khafi, hidden zikr, you can feel the heart is saying Allah, 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 non-stop. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all this has to be within the limits of Sharia. May Allah forgive us. بحرمة الحبيب بحرمة الفاتحة.